Good morning again, everybody.
Good morning.
Brother Andy, would you open us in prayer, please?
Yes, thank you, Father. Lord, just thankful this morning for the opportunity to be here, Lord, to learn more about you. Just pray that you be with those that are sitting here, Lord, and that we open our hearts and minds and receive your word and quieten our lives, Lord. Just be with those in prayer, bring your question for Lord, and your brother, and forgive us our sins and shortcomings. In Jesus' precious name, I pray. Amen.
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 The title of our devotional this morning: the Lord can use men like Barnabas. The Lord can use men like Barnabas. Now, Barnabas was one of the, here leading up to what we're going to talk about this morning. Peter and the apostles got together and they decided that they needed somebody to help control everything. They needed to be in the word of the Lord. They needed to be preaching the gospel and taking care of their duties. And so they picked out men who that they wanted to send out to the missionary field. They needed to go carry this gospel somewhere else, because we're going to mention Stephen here in a minute is actually the one I was thinking about the deaconship. Steve, let me start over. I'll fix and dig myself in a hole. Amen. We're talking about Barnabas this morning, sent out on a missionary journey with Saul. I had Stephen on my mind. It's Stephen's sermon here in a minute, if you'll call it that, is going to be a part of my discussion here in a second. But they chose Barnabas because they wanted to send the missionaries out to the Gentiles. Paul is called Saul. Here is Paul. They went out on the missionary journeys. And it said, now the scripture says, now those who were scattered after the persecution that arose over Stephen traveled as far as Phoenicia. And that's where I was getting at. But remember Stephen. Stephen was stoned to death, and his story can be looked at in Acts chapter 6 and 7. He was accused of blasphemy because he was talking about Jesus and doing away with Moses, and Jesus was bringing in a new covenant. And they drug Stephen down, and they wanted an answer. So Stephen laid a truth bomb on him. He discussed everything that had happened. He preached Jesus to them. And when they heard the truth, when we see where Peter preached in the beginning of Acts, souls were saved. 3,000 was added to the church that day. But when Stephen preached to these people, they got so upset they drug him out and they stoned him to death because of this truth of the gospel. It's great to share a truth. The missionaries that go out, like Barnabas and Paul, they didn't have an easy time of it either. The things that they went through, you can read that Paul discusses that they went through just sharing the gospel. But the Lord chose to use these men to do that. And we wonder sometimes, I don't know what some of our missionaries face personally on the mission fields when they go. We hear about a lot of the successes they have. But what kind of pushback do they have? And yet God will choose them knowing that they're fixing to go into a situation that could cause them their life. Amen? They have to give everything, blood, life, or whatever, for the sake of the gospel. And that's what these men were called for. The Lord can use us, and we're going to discuss this here in a minute. And we have to have no bloodshed. It takes nothing from us sometimes other than to get out of our comfort zone, to get embarrassed like I just did when I started off this devotional the wrong way. But trust me, I've been embarrassed enough up here that it doesn't even bother me. Amen. I'll embarrass myself before it's over with. But that's okay. But the Lord can use us. Are we willing to be used? But he says, for some of the men of Cyprus and Cyrene, who, when they had come to Antioch, spoke to the Hellenists preaching the Lord Jesus. And the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number believed and turned to the Lord. Then news of these things came to the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent out Barnabas to go as far as Antioch. And when he had come and had seen the grace of God, he was glad and encouraged them all that with purpose of heart they should continue with the Lord. For he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith, and a great many people were added to the Lord. Our devotional writer discusses the fact that when Jesus began his church and began his ministry, she uses the word fluid. The church was fluid. In other words, it was wherever Jesus was. It was city to city. It was place to place. It was where the Lord was calling his disciples. It was where the Lord was calling people. He was preaching the gospel and to repent, and people were being saved. People were believing on the Lord Jesus for this. He was healing. He was casting out demons. He was doing everything. It was place to place. And that's where he was, is where his church was. We saw in the book of Acts, when they would go into a city, people were saved. People would meet house to house. The missionaries would go to another city. They would plant a church, and the churches would spring up. People would meet house to house. Here today, we're blessed. We have a building. We can go out. We can go out to our community. We can share the gospel. And there's some missionaries that they'll go in and they'll have to meet in their house until they can find a centralized place where we can gather and meet. And that's what we're blessed with here today, here at Holly Springs. So that's a wonderful thing, because when the Lord poured out his spirit at Pentecost, now the Lord can be right here.
Yeah, amen.
He can be at Southside this morning.
That's right.
He can be at Bethlehem this morning. And he can be wherever through his spirit, as the head of each one of his churches. And that's the awesome thing about it. No longer does he have to physically walk, and his church has to go wherever he goes. He's here with all of us. Mm-hmm. It says before Jesus returned to heaven, that's what we just discussed, he poured out his spirit. The Holy Spirit came upon them so that they were able to do miracles and speak languages that they had never studied. And there were 3,000 new believers from various parts of the traveled world. These new believers needed someone to come and teach them. The church at Jerusalem set aside men who had exemplified that they were faithful and true believers. Barnabas was the first missionary sent out by this church, and he was a great asset in spreading the gospel to the world. Pray and support missionaries. Yeah. You know, when we think about service, we think about all the like missionaries, we think about evangelists, we think about preachers. Are you called? Are you called to be a missionary? We all should be praying, Lord, what would you like me to do? Where would you like me to be in your body? Mm-hmm. And it's great. Are you called to preach? Surrender to preach. Are you called to teach? Surrender to teach. Are you called to be a missionary? Surrender to be a missionary. Don't allow fear. Like I was saying, scared to get out of our comfort zone is the most blood that I ever will have to shed, probably. But there's people all through church history that shed and given everything for the sake of the gospel. Are you called to be a worship leader? Join the choir? These all sound like things that's up front and center, that you have to stand up and have some sort of attention. But let me ask you this. Are you a gifted prayer warrior?
Mm-hmm.
Does the Lord call you to pray? When people have things going on in their life, do they call you, please pray for me? Because they know that you are a prayer. You're a prayer warrior. You pray for people. You make intercession. You give thanks for people. Are you known as that kind of a person? Are you an encourager? Do people come to you just because you encourage? You're not a browbeater. You can share the truth and love in a way that's not offensive to what people are going through. You know, there's people who can, man, I'm stiff, my joints are stiff, and I'm aching. Yeah, well, that's because you get fat. You really need to lose weight. You know what I'm saying? That might offend me a little bit. But there's people, are you an encourager? Can you share the truth with people? Are you a good coordinator? Maybe your job has you in a position, and it's no big, grand, you know, conspiracy of wondering why you might be gifted in a certain area at your job, and the Lord's calling you to be gifted in the same area in your church family. Are you a good coordinator? When there's a loss in the church family or in the community, are you the one that says, hey, I'm going to coordinate this effort, we're going to feed this family, we're going to do these things as a church? Because there's church members who are willing to fall in, but no, you know, they're not gifted in coordinating this. I couldn't coordinate anything. I'm going to tell you that now. But there's people in this church that are gifted. And the first thing that happens, any event, they're jumping in. Hey, we're going to get this going. We're going to have the ball rolling. And everything turns out great. Are you a good listener? Are you quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger? Can people come to you and bring something to you in confidence, and you're not a gossip? You're a good listener, but you're also not a gossip. Do people know you for that? Man, those are needed in church congregations. My point is, we often think of people like Barnabas, Paul, Peter, John. We think about missionaries. We think about pastors. We think about teachers. We think about song leaders. We think about being up here in the choir. We think about being in a special. But do we think about these other things? We're all members of one another. I had a buddy that said, man, all I want to be in the body, if nothing else, is the little toe. Nobody thinks about the little toe, but I want to be in the body. The little toe is important. I want my little toe. I wish I had my index finger back. All of it's important. What's the Lord calling you to do? If you're that type of person in everyday life, you're that type of person in this congregation. It's what you're known for. Do you use your past experiences to help others? Maybe some things that you've gone through can be a help and an aid to another brother or sister. All of this is part. All of this is needed. We don't think about that when we read the Bible, but it's the truth. These people were there. There's unnamed people all through Scripture that the Lord used in these ways. And He's going to remember every one of them one of these days.
True.
There's going to be a time where the Lord's going to reward His faithful servants in whatever He called them to do. And whatever you think may be meaningless or unimportant, it could be the most important. Amen. It's not just about all the big things. The Lord uses, and the Lord uses them for these things, but He uses all of us. He has a specific plan and purpose for each one of our lives. Heavenly Father, I thank You for this day that You've given us the privilege to gather in Your church this morning, Father, and I just pray that we're here for no other reason, Lord, than to lift up the name of Jesus, to exalt You, to honor You. This is Your church, and we thank You for it, Father. We thank You for the people that You place where You place them, Lord. And may we thank You that we've never had to go to bloodshed for Your gospel, Lord, but may we be found to be faithful in service, that if it ever come to that, it's Your will, Father. It's your church. It's Your gospel that's saving this world, Father, because we have brothers and sisters all over the world that's in dangerous situations and dangerous places, where they would love to be able to just sing Your praises in public, to worship You in public, to share their faith in public, and they are in a place where they can't, Father. And we just pray for them this morning, Lord. We pray for Your grace upon them, Your mercy upon them. Father, we thank You for each one that's here this morning. Whatever You call us for, whatever use You have for us, Father, I just pray that we would surrender today, Lord. If we may think it's meaningless, we may think that we're too scared to do it, Father, but by Your grace, we can do whatever You call us to do. I thank You and I love You. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.